Let's go. Now, how does a scientific paper look like? Okay, so let's see. We will proceed to activity number one. All right, so everybody, do you have the paper that says activity one? Half of you will be holding article A. Half of you will be holding article B in here. So this is how the worksheet activity one looks like. So there are four questions in here. So where did this article come from? Letter A question. It has already been answered for you. So are those who are holding article A, it comes from a science magazine. Those who are holding article B, it comes from a science journal. Okay. From now on, what we will do is we will enter a breakout room, and in the breakout room, there will be one pair. One person will be holding article A, one person will be holding article B. And then together, try to answer questions B, C, and letter D. Okay? For question B, do not read yet. Okay? Just look at the paper. What is the difference between the two papers, between article A and article B? And then when you reach question C, try to read the first sentence of article A and then the first sentence of the abstract of article B and try to talk to your partner. Is it difficult? Which one is more difficult? Why is it difficult? Okay? And finally, answer which article looks more scientific. Okay? Is it clear? Let us enter the breakout rooms. You can talk in Japanese. No problem. So in the breakout rooms, can they talk to each other in for 5 minutes? So now let's answer together these questions. All right. So article A came from Science Magazine and article B came from a scientific journal. May I ask you, article B, it came from food chemistry. Food chemistry is one of the scientific journals, but can you see who wrote the paper? Who is the author of that paper?
Mr. Maninang.
Mr. Maninang. Do you know Mr. Maninang? So, yes, it is actually me. This is my sotsuron for my shushi ronbun. So, let's just write here, Maninang. And then, who is the second author? Do you know who the second author is? Usually, when we talk about scientific papers, we refer to them by the family name only. Can you guess what is the family name? Which is the family name of the second author?
Lizada.
Lizada.
Lizada. Yes, very good. So this is Lizada. And how about the third author? And
Gemma. Gemma.
Gemma. Yes, very good. So Gemma. So these are the three authors of this paper. Do you know which year? What year was it written?
2009.
2009.
Yes, this is how we usually refer to a scientific paper. Okay, so this is a paper by Maninang, Lizada, and Gemma in 2009. Okay, next question. How about Article A? Who wrote Article A?
No.
No, there is no information there about who wrote the paper. But what we know is that that is a research which was done by Maninang and Gemma, but we do not know who wrote the paper. Somebody wrote it for them in the science magazine called New Scientist. They were featured. I know who interviewed us, who wrote that paper, but it was not written there. So it is not written. Why is it that in Article B, it's clearly written who is the author, who are the authors? But in Article A, we don't actually know. Anyone?
It doesn't matter
Yes?
since it's a magazine.
It doesn't matter. It's a magazine who wrote it because the nayo of that research, the sekinin, the responsibility is here in the authors who did the research, who did the scientific method. the people who asked the question, who did the background research, who formulated the hypothesis and did the research, they are the ones who are responsible. So it's important who has the responsibility. But in Article A, the person who just wrote about the paper of Maninang, Lizada, and Gemma is not so important, okay? The nayo is more important in here. Sekinin is the keyword, responsibility. That's why it's very important in here. Okay, next question. What visual differences can you see? Anybody?
There's less text on Article A.
Yes. So there is less text on Article A, which means that this may be shorter. And Article B is, of course, longer. Anything else?
The font size is bigger.
The font size is bigger in Article A, but in Article B, this is, okay, font is bigger. And here, it is smaller. Okay, thank you. Anything else?
Article A is using photographs, but Article B is graphs.
Okay, it has photographs. Very nice. Okay, photographs, but here there are graphs. Great. Anything else?
B uses terms, but A is only uses the words that easy to understand for normal people.
Okay, so uses words that are easy to understand for normal people. I think this is going to be here, okay? It's in question letter C. So words are easily understood by common people, okay? One last thing, anyone else? Yes.
Article A has less preferences.
Less references in here. Yes, good. All right, thank you so much. So let's talk about the first one. You know, Article B is longer, but although it is longer, the information is more organized. It is divided into subsections. Did you notice that? Can you tell me what is the first subsection that you can see in Article B?
Introduction.
There is an introduction section in there. How about the next section?
Materials and methods.
The next section?
Results and discussion.
And then?
Conclusion.
We have the conclusion.
Acknowledgements.
We have the acknowledgements. So they are divided into subsections. So although it's longer, the information is grouped together by what kind of information should be together. So we have the introduction, we have the materials and methods section, results and discussion section, conclusion, acknowledgements. But before the introduction, there is another section. You missed it out. What is the
abstract?
We have the abstract, right? We have the abstract. So most of the scientific papers usually are in this format. It is divided into these subsections. Do you know how this format is called? How is a scientific paper formatted? Then you will say, it's divided into abstract, introduction, materials, methods, results and discussion, conclusion, acknowledgement, and references. Chotto nagai desu ne. Ja, how do you call it in a shorter way? Do you know?
IMRAD.
Yes, it's very simple. It is IMRAD. I in here, and then we have the M, R, and the D. So it's very easy to remember. The format of a scientific paper is in the IMRAD format. So you know that it is introduction, methods, results, and discussion. Do not be confused. Sometimes when you see scientific papers, the results are separated from the discussion, okay? So do not be confused that, why is this paper separated with the results and discussion? So this is how, okay? So it's longer, but it is divided into subsections. So the font is smaller. It's longer, but smaller because the information there is more compact. It is complete information in there, okay? And there are graphs in here, and there is a photograph in here. There is a photograph of the durian. May I ask you, if I remove the picture of the durian, of the fruit, in Article A, do you think you can still understand Article A?
Yes.
Yeah. So maybe you will have no idea How does durian look like? Okay, 見た目はどうですか、durian? But still, you know that it's a fruit. It's the one that is causing the bad effect. Still, you can understand the paper without imagining how the durian looks like. But in Article B, if I remove the graph, do you think you can still understand the paper? No. Okay. So, meaning in a scientific report, in a scientific journal paper, anything that you put there has an informative purpose. It has a very important purpose in there. In Article A, the picture of the durian is placed there because it can attract attention. It looks beautiful and it is omoshiroi, right? So in Article B, in a scientific journal, you do not put information, you do not put a picture because it's just omoshiroi, but it should have a very important purpose. And the picture of the durian is not so important for a scientific journal. What's important is the results that are written in the graphs, okay? So any picture in Article B has an informative purpose. In Article A, it has only an aesthetic purpose, okay? So there you go. And then let's go to the next question. Which one is more difficult to understand? You said there that the words are easily understood in Article A, but in Article B, more difficult. Okay, more difficult to understand. May I ask, in Article B, the first sentence of the abstract, what word was difficult for you to understand?
It's the imbibing or
imbibing. Alcohol. Very good. Imbibing. May I ask, after imbibing in that sentence, what was the word? What was the next word?
Alcohol.
Alcohol, right? What do you do with alcohol?
You drink it.
You drink it. Okay, so in layman's terms, in more easily understandable terms, it's about imbibing means drinking. Okay, good. Next word that's difficult for you to understand. Anyone?
Reminiscent.
Reminiscent. All right. All right. So reminiscent in here is difficult to understand. This word is easily found in the dictionary, which means it reminds you. Okay. Any other words? The first sentence only. Okay. The first sentence, any other word that's difficult to understand for you?
The words after durian.
It's difficult to understand. All right. So this is the word after durian. Okay. So this is the gakume of durian. Okay. What else was difficult for you to understand?
Maybe lethal is difficult.
Lethal is difficult to understand. Do you know that in the first sentence of Article A, there is a word there that it exactly means lethal? Can you guess? If you look at Article A, the first sentence also of Article A, there's another word there that means lethal.
Kill.
Kill.
Yes. This means it can kill you. So it is there, okay? Any other word?
King of fruits.
King of fruits. Okay. It's one of the important fruits in here, the king of fruits. Okay. How about Article A? Is there any word that was difficult for you to understand? The first sentence of Article A. Every word is very understandable in Article A, first sentence, right? So why are they using these kinds of words in Article B? Look at this. Instead of drinking, you say imbibing. Reminiscent, it reminds you. Durian, you have to write durio zibitenis mure. Lethal, it actually literally means can kill you. But in Article B, they are using these words because these are more formal words, okay? Imbibing is more formal than drinking. Lethal is more formal than can kill you. You are using formal words in scientific papers. So do not be surprised when you read a scientific paper, it's a little bit more difficult to understand because it is more formal, okay? Why is it formal? Because the report that is in Article B in a journal paper is very important. Something important, you treat it more importantly. For example, if you are invited to a birthday party, what will you wear if it's the birthday party of your classmate? You will only wear a casual wear, right? Just something regular. But what if it's the birthday party of the Emperor of Japan? You will wear something which is more formal. So that's why scientists, when they write scientific papers, because the content is very important, they use more formal words. How about this? So the point is, it is formal. Okay, this is more formal. And then one more thing, Duryo Zibithinus Murei, the Gakume of Durian. Do you know that Durian has so many shuruis? It has Sanju Ichis shurui, but only one can be eaten. The other ones are already poisonous. Only Duryo Zibithinus Murei is edible. So we are very specific also in scientific papers. Okay? We have to be specific in scientific papers. So it's formal and it is specific. Finally, I think everybody agrees. Which one is more scientific?
B
is more scientific. It is more formal, it is specific, and it is more complete. Okay? So that is a scientific paper. Let me go back to my PowerPoint presentation. You know now, the scientific paper is divided into subsections called the IMRAD format, okay? And the IMRAD format is actually based on the scientific method. The first three steps, all the information that you know, your research question, the background research that you found out, the kasetsu is written in the introduction section. How did you do the experiment? It's written in the methods. What did you find out? It's the results section. And then, based on your analysis, what do you think? Is the hypothesis supported by the results or not? And why is it supported? That's where the discussion comes in. So the IMRAD is based also on the scientific method. So please do not forget this too, the scientific method and the IMRAD and how they are connected to each other. Okay, so this is the one, the IMRAD. All right, I'm going to skip this later on, but my point here is that scientific paper in Google Scholar that is written in the IMRAD format is only three kinds of scientific papers, okay? So there are many kinds of scientific papers in Google Scholar. Not only those that are written in IMRAD format, there are also other reports like pictorial essay, there is a review, there is a commentary, there is an editorial. So do not be surprised when you search in Google Scholar and you get a paper and you will say, wait a minute, this paper is not in the IMRAD format. Okay, so do not be confused. There are other reports not in the IMRAD paper. There are only three kinds of papers, but you know, these three kinds, original article, case report, technical note, they are written in the IMRAD format, and almost 80% of scientific papers that you will get from Google Scholar is in the IMRAD format, okay? So, as I've said, the scientific papers, not all of the scientific papers are in the IMRAD format. Most of them are in the IMRAD format. So the paper about durian, Article B, is an example of an original article because the findings is new, something that has not been researched in the past. That's why it's called an original article. And the other articles that are in the IMRAD format are a case report, a technical note. Those that are not are pictorial essay, review. I will not explain anymore one by one all of this. So just note that not all credible scientific papers are in the IMRAD format. Some of them may not be in the IMRAD format, okay? Only these three are in the IMRAD format, okay?